Hello everybody, my name is Eric Navas. In this video I'm going to talk about why I left El Camino UBF, which is also using another name, Shepherd's Church Gardena. The reason why I left is because of the trail. The trail is not only tolerated and condoned there, but it's also advocated. I came to this realization when John Beck told me, in his own words, quote, "You don't belong anywhere. You're a waste of life." You've never been a part of us. And I felt betrayed that way. I wonder myself, since I was there for 3 years, was that all for nothing? I was there from 2013 to 2016. And at that moment I made the decision to leave. So before I left, I wanted to make sure my decision was permanent, was final. I wanted to leave, not just physically, but leave mentally and figuratively as well. So what I started doing was talking to ex-members and kind of forming a support group. I also talked to ex-counselors, or talked to anti-cult groups, cult watch groups. I started reconnecting with my family, and I started regaining my personality, because when I was in UBF, I was basically a clone. But luckily, I didn't erase 100% of my personality. I diminished probably about 90% of it. And so from that 10%, I started to expand on that. So when that was done, I started, stopped doing all the UBF activities. I stopped going to testimony night, I stopped doing testimony writing, I stopped going to the fellowship meetings. And then when I felt for sure that I no longer have any lingering to be in there, I left. It's kind of ironic because I left on October 31st, 2016. Nobody chased after me. Nobody called me after I left. Nobody asked why I left. Which showed that all the friendships you develop there, they're not real. At best, they're superficial. You see, UBF is not a ministry, it's a business. You only have friends and connections based on certain conditions. If you do what they want you to do and be who they want you to be. And that's the case, that's not real friendship at all. And my story is not the first story, and unfortunately may not be the last. In the description below, I'm going to put links to stories of other ex-members who left there as well. And if you're a new member at this church watching this video, I would ask that you at the very least, hear what I have to say and what they had to say. Now whether you believe it or not, that's up to you. If there's questions you want to ask us, please feel free to contact us. I'll leave my contact in the description below as well. So that's why he left. And it wasn't easy either, because UBF is a cult addiction. To overcome any addiction, you need to do two things. One, you have to remove yourself from the toxic person, group, thing that's doing harm to you. And the second thing you gotta do is find a healthy substitute. When you don't do that, there's a happiness you're going back to that toxic thing or person. Because your brain, there's a science behind it. I'm not a science guy, so to speak. Basically, your brain tells you that the only way to find dopamine or relaxation is to go back to that toxic thing. And addiction is a very serious thing. So if you're a new member and you're planning on to leave, just know that you're not alone. Your struggle is, how can I say it? Circle is not just for you to bear all by yourself. There's people out there who are willing to help you, who's willing to listen to you, who respect you for who you are, who be friends with you based on who you are. And what I learned after leaving is that there are people who are willing to accept me. That there is a place I could belong. Alex, Frank Archer, Chris, Kenny, Ashley Brown, Ashley Easter, Josh, just to name a few people. They're important in my life. They stick me for who I am. I don't have to change myself to be around them. And after leaving, I learned what real friendship really is. So if you're struggling, you're not alone. I'm willing to struggle with you. I'm willing to go through that same struggle of leaving. However, in the end of the day, it's for your decision to decide on that. Just know that I'm here always. If you're a new member and you leave, if you don't want to talk to me for whatever reason, I'm okay with that. Because in the end of the day, we're all sovereign people. I will have nothing against you, but I always will leave my hand open if you wish to shake it, if you wish to take my hand, so to speak, as a sign of friendship. So please don't feel like you have to talk to me, you have to understand me. It's an option.